This is a story that broke yesterday afternoon. The FBI says there's been a second assassination attempt on former President Donald Trump, this time at his golf course in Florida. For the latest on this investigation, CTV's Christina Tenaglia joins us. So let's talk more about where this happened and how it was stopped.
Yeah, so this took place yesterday afternoon, Nick, in West Palm Beach, Florida, at Trump's golf course. And thankfully, it was stopped, unlike the first assassination attempt in Butler, Pennsylvania, about, 9 weeks ago. I want to emphasize, Nick, you know, it's something a congressman pointed out this morning. We're not just talking about an assassination attempt. When we talk about this now, it's which one? There has been two. This is unprecedented in such a short period of time. So Trump was golfing on his course, and Secret Service agents spotted a person concealed in the bushes and holding a rifle. Trump was golfing. He was, you know, a few hundred, they say yards, but meters away is what I'll point out. The Secret Service shot at the man. Trump was not injured, again, unlike that previous attempt. The suspect fled, but local law enforcement credit a witness who saw this guy in his getaway vehicle, and law enforcement was able to catch up with him. Again, this is something, as expected, that is being condemned from both sides of the aisle. Political violence is unacceptable. And then the questions are coming this morning. Actually, President Joe Biden just spoke quickly to reporters in which he pointed out the need for more personnel and protection for President Donald Trump. As a former president and a current presidential candidate, he, of course, has Secret Service protection, but not at the level that a sitting president has. Speaker Mike Johnson saying this morning, considering the unprecedented nature of this second assassination attempt, President Trump needs more personnel.
Mm. Okay, and Christina, what do we also know about the alleged or would-be shooter here?
Yeah, so this is a man who, he's from North Carolina. He has pledged his allegiance to Ukraine. He actually spoke to the New York Times a year ago as someone who expressed interest in traveling to Ukraine to fight. He's had a lot of posts about this as well. He has a criminal background, so he's got a bit of a criminal record. What's interesting is that he, you know, in terms of what we know, he had a, in terms of how the setup of this assassination attempt. He had a GoPro. He was able to get away. He was not someone, as one law enforcement expert pointed out, that was interested in taking his own life. This is someone who, based on his social media post, is politically motivated in some way. His name is Ryan Wesley Routh, 58 years old. He, of course, is in police custody. The FBI is leading this investigation. Nick, if I can share one more thing, it's President Trump's post on Truth Social, in which he thanked everyone for their concern. He even thanked the U.S. Secret Service for keeping him safe, which they did. But once again, there are these questions around why did this even happen? Mm-hmm. Why was this man able to get so close to the golf course? And also, how did he know Trump was there? Questions about access and even, you know, the perimeter that's set up at the golf course. Pointing out, Nick, that, of course, a golf course being a massive facility is challenging to protect and to secure.
Yeah, there certainly are a lot of questions in the wake of this one. That is CTV's Christina Tenaglia. Christina, appreciate this. Thanks.
Okay.